Hallo? Hallo? Okay, I thought we were muted. We weren't. My stream was just muted. Very dumb of me. Hello, bitch, Zephor. I gotta love it when I accidentally mute my stream, thinking that I accidentally muted my mic or something, when really it was just something dumb like that. I feel very unclean, very messily done tonight. Anyway, Danganronpa. We're doing Danganronpa. We're on chapter 6 now. This chapter is the final chapter and is by far the coolest. So there's no daily life in this chapter at all. I mean, there's a tiny little section. But most of it is investigation and a big trial at the end. So we're splitting it into two streams because it's a massive investigation, massive trial. So this stream is the investigation. The actual final finale of this game will be on Thursday. Hey Rose, can you even chat icons yet? The stream's loading fine. Good job. Your internet is very pogchamp. You mean it not an update so that tomorrow's stream's on 6:30? Tomorrow's stream, yes. Because Minecraft streams, I mean Tato streams, there's not really much reason to wait until 7:30. Because it's Tato, we're just vibing anyway. It's not like people are missing things if they, show up late kind of thing. It's just we're just playing on Tato. There is actually some things that I do need to fix before then. So it might be a quite technical stream, either that or I don't stream at all. I don't know yet. Because there are the Nether portals are completely fucked. Completely fucked. And I have no idea what's causing them. So if I do stream tomorrow, bear that in mind. Anyway, we do some Danganronpa. I'm thirsty. Okay, we good. Hello, Ham Chorblor. How are you doing on this Chorblor day? Also, hello, like, shut the fuck up. That's my joke, bitch. So. Hello, still ill. That's also not poggers. The Nether is functional. It's just going, basically going from the Nether to the overworld through a portal fucks up the portals. Like you go through a Nether portal, through the Nether, into the overworld, and it doesn't link the portals. It just generates a new one every single time. Every time you go to the overworld from the Nether, it generates a new portal. Even if there's already a portal there, it will make another one next to it. Without fail, every single time. And I don't know what's causing that. Because I have touched nothing related to portals. And they're fucked. Anyway, I'll try and fix it when I can. It's just the problem is I have touched nothing related to portals. So I don't know what's causing it. Anyway, Danganronpa, final investigation. So one, this stream will be the big investigation. Thursday, the big trial. They're very good, I promise you. Desktop audio, dang, daily life. So there is a small. Oh, okay. Game being a little funky. There you go. So there is a daily life to this, but it's not really a daily life. It's more or less just investigation. There's no death, it's just investigation. I heard world border stuff can be weird with portals. No, that's not it. That's not it. Trust me, it's weird. I don't know what's causing it. Anyway, it's not the focus right now. We're playing Dangly Ranmas, Chapter 6. I hope you can. Yeah, it is, Ham. This is the best part of the game. Leon didn't kill anyone today. Can you guys hear the game all right? Can you guys hear the game all right? You cannot hear the game at all, can you? I'll bring it up a little bit. How's this? Okay, because the game is quiet. I just want things to be a good volume and I can't test it and stuff. Also, I will be actually doing a cut down version, which I'll be uploading to YouTube, because Sean has been so kind and they're letting me use their Adobe account so I can edit, because it's so fucking expensive. Adobe, it's overpriced, it's crazy. So I will be editing the Danganronpa streams into a kind of series, and it'll be POG. Why is Sayako on the title screen? We don't know. Anyway, also that does mean the lore video will be hopefully soon, because let me tell you something, editing with DaVinci Resolve, it's fucking dreadful. Okay. Chapter 5 ending. This is chapter 6 start. I fucking love New World Order. Okay. Yeah, that's the thing with Adobe, that their software's really good and their ecosystem is really good. It's just so fucking expensive. Like, even when I had the student membership, it was still like £25 a month. It's good if you're a business, because you can afford that, but if you're just one person, that is expensive as shit. Yeah. Okay, anyway. I need to lubricate my voice. I just love how over the course of this game, I feel like my voice acting has slightly improved. It's still really shit, but it's slightly getting there. Shut the fuck up. Okay. It has improved a little bit. Like, I haven't nailed a voice for each character. Like, my voices for certain characters, they're all over the place. But I feel like when it comes to the expression, the emotion, I think I'm getting that, at least. Okay. Yeah, I've been using Paint on Net. That's fine for me. Just editing is a big thing for me, and I need good software. Okay. We'll zone out about Adobe. We'll shut up with Adobe. We'll shut up with the Tato server. That, we'll leave that for tomorrow. For now, Dangly Grandma. Like, that's when Mako was going to tell you. Made him sound actually pissed. I liked that. I was proud of the way I'd done that. Okay. The Ultimate Despair. A group of people who caused the tragedy 1 year ago. Those same people put together this killing game and began broadcasting it around the world. The most desperately awful group of people ever. That is the Mastermind's true identity. Our enemy has finally been revealed. It's Kyoko. But right now...
Anyway...
Right now, we have to get out of this horrible place. Figure out the rest of the story can come after. And his name is Leon Uwat. Shut up. Yeah, you're right. Let's fucking do this. Come on, Kyoko. Let's get the fuck out of this fucking place. Kyoko, do you still have that one thing? Monokuma's secret tool. You got from the headmaster's room?
Indeed.
Of course I do. It's an absolutely vital piece of ensnare... piece? It's an absolutely vital part of ensnaring the mastermind. I would never part with it. Which also put me on 180p. I god love being on 180p. I also love doing a 180 degrees. Mukuro Ikusaba. I spin. Don't you ever say secret tool again. And it can open any door in the school, right?
That's right.
That's right. We should be able to use it on that door, right? Let's fucking get the fuck out of- here! Hey, Kyoko, can we use that key of yours to open this door, right? Maybe as long- Oh, I have! Literally, 20 minutes ago, I was on call with Sean, and I was literally completely, like, dozing off. I was just- I had no energy at all. I don't know where this energy came from. I think it's just the hype of finishing this game. I've done it so many times, but I fucking love this game. So showing you all, most of you have already seen the ending, but some of you haven't. So showing off the ending, it's just, I fucking love the ending of this game. It's so fucking cool. The big plot twist at the end, it's fucking cool. Anyway, I wake up on stream. Yep, I was right. Who was Pog? She did, apparently. Hey Kyoko, we can use the key of yours to open this door, right? The one thing I do need to do is actually slow down my talking, because I talk really fast and I can't keep up with the words on screen, in the sense of I skip words and I say the wrong words because I'm just winging it. So I need to slow down. I need to calm down. Mukuro Ikusaba, the 16th student lying hidden somewhere in this school. The one they call the ultimate despair. Why am I doing the Italian thing? Mamma mia, the ultimate despair. Okay, let's find out. Kyoko took out the key with the Monokuma design on it and slid it into the keyhole. I'm not usually this fast. I know I can't keep up. And then... the door opened! Oh, fuck! Never would have guessed. Yes, it opened! As if we were... Makoto, do you really think the main character would just be stuck in a room for the rest of his life? No. It's the dance of Italy. The door opens with the key? What sort of plot twist would it be if the protagonist is stuck in a room and can't get out? Oh, whoa, whoa. Okay, I'll calm down now. I'll try to anyway. And now we can get out of here. Let's go. Sounds good. Yeah, I can definitely see the difference in you and you and other streams. Yeah, I don't know why I'm so lively. I was like dozing off like half an hour ago. We quickly opened the door and made our escape from the garbage pit. We left Libby alone in her habitat. And on the other side of the door, Sayaka. The protagonist just stays in the room for 5 hours the entire chapter. Like, literally an entire chapter, we were just stuck in a completely separate place and you cannot get out. Imagine that. I'm really craving some strawberries. Maybe even some grapes, I don't know. We were finally free. Leon Kawata Shrine. Leon Kawata Shrine. We were finally free. But there wasn't even time to take a breath of relief. You know what this means, guys. Let's see the fucking body. There's no body. I'm sorry. Because the real fight had just begun. Chapter 6. Ultimate pain, ultimate suffering, ultimate despair, ultimate execution, ultimate death. Straight to Deadly Life, by the way. It said Deadly Life. No one died, but we're still going to Deadly Life. It seems fitting. Holy shit, Sans is behind the door. Oh. The garbage area actually has all the previous Leon clones. After leaving the garbage pit, we found ourselves in a tunnel extending straight up like a chimney. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's a long chapter. There's long chapter names. Like, chapter 2 is like, what is it? Boy's Life of Despair. That's a nice length one. Then there's chapter 3. It's like fucking... I don't even know what it was, but it was just a very long one. And then there's chapter 6. Ultimate pain, execution, ultimate despair, everything. Okay, there was a metal ladder leading up into the tunnel. We started climbing the ladder, intent on reaching the surface. The ladder was impossibly long. I couldn't even see where it ended. It's a very long ladder, what can I say? On the top of the ladder is your mum. I'm going right back down. I saw a little image of this scene. A little fan art of this scene. And it just shown Makoto standing at the bottom of the ladder saying ladies first. Kyoko was pissed. Anyway. The ladder... Right. We climbed into darkness. The passage was so dark and cramped I couldn't even see my own feet beneath me. Someone likes this art too much. Yep, there's bound to be someone. I had no idea we were so far down. I mean, Makoto, you fucking fell that far and you were completely fine. Fall damage does not exist in the Danganronpa universe. Never mind, yes it does. 100% lie.
Hey.
Don't lose your footing. If you slip, I will not be able to catch you. Yeah, I'll be careful. But now that you said that, I'm getting kind of nervous. Maybe talking will help keep my mind off it. So, Kyoko, there's something I wanted to ask you.
Who is Joe?
You said you're the ultimate detective, right? So, how long have you been doing detective work? He's the main character. Full damage is off for him. Joe Nuts. How long?
So.
Ever since I can remember. I come from a long line of detectives. Detective work is my blood. There was a time when being a detective was considered a sacred duty. My family's always seen it that way. Then, is your family famous?
Wrong.
Quite the opposite, actually. Even among us, even among actual detectives, many people haven't heard of us. I mean, that sentence does contain the words among us. They're just separated by 7 words. It's close enough. It's within venting distance. There's a chapter from another game I play that's called Those That Live on This Planet and Those That Have Come on This Planet. To this planet. That is a long chapter name. That's a long chapter name. I hope those pink, the talents are in their blood. Huh? But how come? It's just like your family tradition, right? So.
Right.
Because we take pride in it. Pride?
Indeed.
A detective is neither light nor shadow. We represent neither justice nor evil. That is how we can uncover the absolute truth. We stand neutral in all things, and to do that, we have to stand separate from the rest of society. Which is why we've made a conscious effort to conceal our existence. Conscious effort?
It's true.
It's kind of old-fashioned, and I can't say it's entirely rational. But it's our family creed, and we do what we must to protect it. Because, like I said, it's our source of pride. So that explains. Before I came here, when I was looking up info at the school online, I never saw anything about her. Because she hid herself on purpose to protect the pride of her family.
However,
her arms are strong, hope you die at the climb. Yeah! My arms would be fucking dead after going up 2 steps. And yet, I gave up some of that pride. In order to enter Hope's Peak, I had to reveal myself to the school. I did it knowing that it was something a true Kirigiri detective would never do. But the reason you gave up that pride, the reason you go so far to enter Hope's Peak, is it was because that's how much you wanted to reconnect with your dad, right? There's no shame in that.
What?
Reconnect? I had absolutely no desire to reconnect with my father. But you'd be reuniting after all those years, right? You'd have so much to talk about.
Wrong.
There's nothing I want to talk to my father about. I've actually forgotten the voices. That's the problem with me. I think I'm getting slightly better at like emotions and things. The problem I'm struggling with is actually having a voice for these characters. I can't change my voice. I do not know how to do that. What if the game was set in 2010? I probably would know what the game is set in 2010 or around that time. So yeah, Makoto might know what a troll face is. Kyoko probably not. Chihiro definitely would.
However,
there is something I wanted to say to him, though. What? No matter what it takes, I have to find him and tell him face to face. What is it?
So
I want to sever all ties with him. That was an epic fail, Monokuma. When he doesn't kill Makoto. Oh, that was an epic fail. Am I right, lads? Oh, am I right, lads? Yeah, it was 2010. It was around that time. Sever? The last time I saw him, I was still very young. So I don't remember myself, but apparently he was extremely intelligent. He was in line to become the next head of the Kirigiri family. He was talented and had a promising future. Wouldn't have Discord yet. Oh no, I mean Discord mod would probably have like Reddit or something. When was Reddit made? It was definitely before 2010, surely. so he still had read it.
However,
but he had no interest in detective work. So he cut himself off from the family. Not long after that, my mother died, and he simply ran away. He went to my grandfather, and they had a huge argument, and as young as I was, he left me behind. He was probably Skype mod back then. It's a fucking mod of like MSN or something. I'm sure there was a reason for that. I'm sure your dad wanted to take you with him.
Right.
If that's true, then I need to thank him. Thank him for leaving me. Because unlike him, I take pride in the work I do. I take pride in my family name. So every last part of me is happy he didn't take me with him. If I'd gone with him, I never would have had the chance to become a detective. It hasn't fight. So was YouTube. That's crazy. I was above Kyoko on the ladder, so I wasn't able to see her expression. So I couldn't tell. I couldn't see how she looked when she said that, but what she might have been feeling. Chad Kyoko goes up to a respected academy, goes up to her headmaster father, tells him to not see him ever again, leaves. All I could tell was that compared to her usual self, she was more talkative and more emotional.
I
don't blame him, you know, he had his own life to live. That's what anyone in my position might say, right? But it's not true.
However,
but there is one thing that I can never forgive.
So
the way everyone else looked at me. I was never sad about being left behind. Like I said, I think it was a good thing.
However,
when the rest of my family looked at me, they saw something different. They only saw me as the little girl that was abandoned by her father. That's how they see me even to this day. His shadow's been following me my entire life. I'm sick of it. I need him out of my life. I need to step out of his shadow.
Correct.
That's why I have to find him and tell him we're no longer family. Oh my god, compliment? Okay, Rose, you're very PogChamp. You're very PogChamp, Rosalou. Dev's very proud of this image, clearly. Just wait until we get to the second game. There's one character in that game which has her moments. And yes, people who have seen the second game, I said her moments. That character. Let's just say they're very clumsy. You know exactly who I'm talking about. In order to settle the past, in order to remove him from my life forever, I have no doubt he forgot about me years ago. But your family, to just cut him out like that?
Wrong.
Our only connection is through blood. Nothing more. I'm screenshotting that because I feel that. Is the second game an island game? I'm not saying anything about the second game. The second game is just very fucking good though, and it also has Best Girl. Actually, no. But the second game is very cool. Actually, there is one scene. There is one scene. But we do not discuss that scene yet. Are we connected by heart and soul? No.
Hey.
Is blood really enough to call someone family? I was so shocked to hear her say something like that. I didn't know how to respond. So instead, I said nothing. I just kept climbing the ladder in complete silence. And after I don't know how long, we finally reached the top. Looks like this is it.
Indeed.
On the other side of this door, Hope's Peak is waiting for us. We're back.
That's right.
Remember that hatch on the ground near the trash room? I'm fairly certain this is where we'll come out. I unlocked it earlier, so it should open without much trouble. Well, there goes nothing. I reach my right hand up and push against the hatch. Bam, 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 bam. The hatch opened with ease, and so... Oh my fucking god, we're alive! Looks like we're back. But I can't believe how long that ladder was. I'm exhausted. I can't exactly say we're safe and sound, but at least we're out of here. Now we're back in Hope's Peak Academy. Kyoko, thank you. I never would have gone out there without you. The slow ladder climbers. Nah, they were just at bedrock level. No thanks necessary. I'll just return in the favor. So, now what do you do? I'm glad I didn't die, of course, but if the mastermind finds out... And I'm worried about you too. You helped me, so they might...
Listen.
You're worried? Yeah, of course. 1.18. Yeah, they're quite deep. And Hope's Peak Academy happens to be built on top of a mountain. So it's quite a climb.
So then.
Let's just get a concrete answer.
Huh? In other words,
let's ask Monokuma if there's a problem with you escaping. Wait, this. However, if we try to hide, it's only a matter of time until we're found out. And it's not like we can run away. As she said that, she pointed at the nearby surveillance camera. She was saying, rather than stressing out about getting caught, we should just give up now. It was Leon's. Don't worry. What you think is going to happen isn't.
Because
the mastermind is the one that's ensnared. You said something like that before. What does it mean? Standing where Leon stood. Oh my god, that's a Leon reference. Hope's Peak.
So
the mastermind stood exposed during the investigation into Mukuro's death. There was a moment where the mastermind let their guard down. There was?
Right.
If we can talk to Monokuma, we can confirm it. It would be better for us if we go to him directly before he tracks us down. That should help with our negotiations. I'm still a little, no, super uneasy about this, but we don't really have a choice, do we?
Indeed.
Monokuma should be in the gym.
Shall we go?
Let's get going. Let's fucking go. Bam 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 bam. I think hey, my mouse is like moving around freely. Okay, that seems normal. Okay. Let's fucking go. I'm very cring. Right, so, what's going on, I hear you ask. Makoto has climbed out of the big fucking hole, and now they're basically like, okay, so we can't really hide from Monokuma. There's cameras everywhere, they know we're back. They know that I'm alive, they know I'm here. So if we approach him and discuss something, I might be allowed to live.
Well, now.
Kyoko, I don't mind so much. But Makoto's supposed to be dead. What's he doing here? That's exactly how I thought he'd react. Are we really going to be okay? You were supposed to be punished. Did Kyoko help you?
What?
Sort of, I did. What will you do? I'm talking so fast. If the guilty party is exposed during the class trial, they alone will be executed. He's not allowed to live. It's unfortunate, but that is the rule. So now I've got to punish you again, and this time I won't leave anything to chance. Kyoko, do whatever you feel you have to. What? But before you do, let me say just one thing. If you execute Makoto, that means you lose. Not that that matters to you, right? Huh? I lose?
Hey!
You, explain yourself! What do you mean by that? I'm so shit with voices, my god.
Because.
Well, you set up this latest class trial yourself, right? I was getting in your way, so you wanted an excuse to kill me.
In other words,
I was supposed to be chosen at the Black End and then executed, right?
Yeah.
What are you talking about?
However,
but when Makoto chose to overlook my lie, your plan came crashing down. The results of the trial were not all what you were expecting. Because you never imagined that in that position, one person would protect another like that.
Right.
And in response to that unexpected development,
indeed,
you reacted by proclaiming Makoto the Blackened and trying to execute him. You made the choice out of desperation. No, more than that. You must have realized that Makoto, who refused to be manipulated, was a threat to you as well.
However,
but then there was another unexpected development waiting for you. An entity that you would throw a wrench, so to speak, in your precious execution machinery. Alter ego. You never imagined the possibility of a being that could come to our aid even after you've killed it.
Am I wrong?
Now here's the absolute truth. Makoto didn't kill Mukuro, you did. So executing Makoto for it would surely be a violation of your rules, which I know you love so much. If the Blacken is exposed, they alone will be executed. That's what you told us, right? And that means I lose? You talk a big game. You're saying the black hen is me and not Makoto?
Well,
and you can prove this, right?
Well,
no, I can't. Don't just say it like that. What is this, a comedy routine? With such bold claims out of a shred of evidence?
That doesn't matter.
I don't have any right now, but with a little more time, I guarantee I'll find some. I know a good ending would be Hina killing someone and getting away with it to leave her. Yeah, I mean, he seems like Hina more than anyone else.
That's right.
Because no matter how deeply you try to bury it, there is only one absolute truth. And now you're trying to talk like some kind of famous detective type.
Because
if Makoto really was the killer, he never would have come to you willingly like this. He would have feared for his life, feared another execution. He would have tried to run and hide. He would have been gripped by the despair you love to inspire. Hey Haley, investigators be investigating. Oh yes, we will, Dee. But here we are, confronting you with nothing but hope in our hearts. And that's supposed to be enough to convince me in this absence of evidence?
Indeed.
It's not you I'm trying to convince.
Hey.
If you were to execute Makoto now, everyone out there watching this would be extremely displeased.
Huh? Indeed.
Imagine what everyone out there would think if you killed Makoto. They would assume that you killed him because what we said is exactly right.
Listen to me.
Despair can never kill hope.
Hey.
Of course, you can say we're just making this all up. You're welcome to prove us wrong. No, you have no choice but to prove it. Because if you kill Makoto without proving your own innocence, you'll be accepting your own defeat. If you want to earn our despair fair and square, then I suggest you take my advice. So, what is this advice of yours? Kyoka's basically saying the story would suck from like a writing standpoint if Makoto dies here. 100%.
It's true.
To do Mukuro's trial over again. Only this time you follow the school regulations to ensure a fair trial.
It's time for one last showdown. One final battle between hope and despair.
I fucking love Kyoka's voice actor. It's really fitting. It's really cool.
Hey.
Well, that would make for a proper climax, wouldn't you say? A fair trial, one last showdown. In other words, this will be our chance to be a big shot, to expose the true identity of Mukuro's killer, the mastermind themselves. But what reason would the mastermind have to accept the challenge? They'll probably just execute me with another word. Interesting.
Bear it!
Very interesting indeed. Barry?
What's wrong?
Oh, I was getting bored, so I decided to change things up a little. So, time for bear jokes. Now, what you suggested might be plausible. It would certainly make for one honey of a climax.
In other words,
does that mean you accept?
You guys!
If we do things your way, that'll be enough to convince you and the viewers, right? And it would cause you unbearable despair, right? Then I'm prepared to agree to your terms. Will you hope with your hope win out? Or will my despair claim victory? Let's have one final grisly showdown. Agreed? Then we still have a big shot at this.
Bear it.
But this is the long awaited climax, right? Just guessing the killer is barely a fitting end.
You guys.
So for this final face-off, you have to unearth all the mysteries that have been buried here. All the mysteries? That's right. Every last mystery that's pouring around the school. If you can do that, then that'll be enough to qualify as a victory for you. PRB, the puns are unbearable.
It's true.
That's what we've been trying to do all along. Okay, well, good. Then let's bear it all. If you can claw your way to the truth of Mukuro's death and solve the mysteries of this school, then you win. But if you can't do all that, we'll all face execution, right? I can barely contain my excitement. When you learn the whole truth, what kind of despair will you show me? We're as excited as you are, I'm sure.
Listen to me.
When we've uncovered every last truth, how will the ultimate despair reveal their own despair? I honestly can't believe how this is all turned out.
Hey.
But before we get started, I want to clarify one more thing. Do you remember the rule? When one student kills another, that's when a class trial is held.
What's wrong?
I remember that for sure. So what?
Hey.
I just want to confirm. That is what you said, right? And it's a true statement. You don't have to be so suspicious. You don't have to be so suspicious. I've said it before, but it bears repeating. Everything is based on the school regulations, and having a trial for Mukuro is no exception to that. Mukuro's trial is no exception? Then it's part of the regulations? Which would have to mean that whoever killed Mukuro... It's a very polarizing approach, I know, but... Okay, enough puns. Anyway, here's a hint. I'm sure I told you this already, but... This killing game began with 16 participants, all of them high school students. And the only people to take a single step in Oathspeak since the killing game began are those 16 students.
What? Listen.
Are you telling the truth? Why are you quiet all of a sudden? I'm done talking. I've got nothing left to say to you. So get lost, would you? You're so mad. He seems emotionally unstable. Oh my god, me! Hey. Leave me alone, get out of here! Okay, I'm just... You really gonna let me go? I don't even care anymore. You're gonna get your punishment later anyway. I need to start getting it ready. A super duper extra special punishment, overflowing with despair.
Hey.
Come on, Makoto, let's go. Okay. So, basically what happened there is Monokuma's like, okay, no, Kyoko was like, okay, so, your rule, a class trial is only held when a student kills another student. So is that actually the case with Mukuro's, you know, killing? And then Monokuma was like, okay, so the only people who have ever taken a step inside of Oathspeak Academy since the killing game began were the 16 students. Nobody else. And Mukuro's case is no exception. So she was killed by one of those 16 students. Hopefully that makes sense. And just like that, we're out of the gym. I can hardly believe it, but somehow I ended up not getting executed. I still had my life, and we still had a chance to be a big shot. Overall, things turned out way better than expected. Once again, I was in Kyoko's debt. Kyoko, thank you. Everything I have right now is because of you.
However,
don't thank me just yet. The real battle is still ahead of us. Yeah, true. But still, I'm glad it worked out. I wasn't sure if the enemy would accept my proposal. But honestly, why would the mastermind agree to that? I mean, they don't stand to gain anything from a final showdown, do they?
So
they had no choice but to accept.
Because
it's all because of that one moment the mastermind let their guard down. Like I said. So when was it the mastermind let their guard down?
So
I wasn't there to hear it myself, but do you remember what the mastermind said? They said they had hijacked the airwaves to broadcast our school life to the outside world, right? In Portugal, we have a saying that's literally translated as doing a bear figure, which means embarrassing yourself. How fitting to that. Very funny. Fucking love that. I love that so much. They said they had hijacked the airwaves to broadcast our school life to the outside world, right? Yeah, they definitely said that.
Listen.
And what do you think? What did you think when you heard that? Pretty hard to believe, right? Well, I mean, the idea of actually taking over the airwaves seems so unbelievable.
Indeed.
You don't exactly read about something like that happening very often, so it's hard to imagine. In other words, that kind of thing is extremely difficult to pull off.
However,
and yet somehow the mastermind was able to do it.
In other words.
But think of it another way. There must have been some reason they had to do something like that.
So
they had to show the world something, no matter the cost, us killing each other. They wanted to show the world? The mastermind has been very adamant about not killing us directly, but forcing us to kill each other. And all of their rules and regulations were designed to encourage that. Yeah, I mean, that makes sense. If those stupid regulations didn't exist, nobody would have killed anybody.
In other words,
so the mastermind's ultimate goal was to make us kill each other and show that off to the world. But why?
Correct.
To prove a point, most likely. Hey. The outside world is a name for the students of Hope Speak, right? A certain concept. So I hope, right?
That's right.
And for those of us who represent hope to kill each other and sink into despair, the Mastermind wants the world to see that, to try and prove that despair is better than hope. That's their goal, is the ultimate despair. They want to prove that despair is better than hope? But that's ridiculous.
It's true.
You're right, it is ridiculous, completely irrational. It's the kind of thing that nobody but those who call themselves the ultimate despair would devise. Kind of the hope counter from the beginning. I would love to say I'm actually going to have an actual hope counter when editing them down, but I'm going to lose count. Oh, I bet you would, Ham. I bet you would. The group who that group whose only purpose and motivation comes from despair. Is that really the only reason for making us, the rest of us, suffer?
Makoto.
I know how angry it must make you, and yet that same motivation is what led to the Mastermind revealing their weakness.
In other words,
because their goal is to broadcast this killing game to the world, the Mastermind has had to be more particular than is reasonable by their own regulations. If the Mastermind simply ignored their rules, this wouldn't have been a game, but a one-sided slaughter.
At least,
that's how those who are watching this would have seen it. And that's why the Mastermind couldn't kill any of us themselves.
Indeed.
That is precisely the reason. No matter how much they may hate what I'm doing, I haven't violated a single one of their regulations. Junko broke the rules, so she was punished. But in my case, they couldn't lay a finger on me.
Right.
So instead they tried to use the class trial, following all their proper rules, to get me killed. They began a trial that didn't have a right answer and made me out to be the killer. But even that didn't work.
It's true.
Yeah, thanks to you. And due to that failure, the Mastermind took yet another risk. They attempted to kill you instead, who also was not the killer. When that fact was exposed on live TV to the entire outside world, the Mastermind had to accept your suggestion.
Indeed.
To prove to the world that despair is better from hope, they have to defeat us in perfect form.
In other words,
it would only do the Mastermind harm to have it shown that they violated their own regulations. But all of that was a hunch, right? And you were still able to get the Mastermind to accept your challenge?
However,
well, it's only thanks to you that we've got the chance. Because you believed in me, another path opened up. If it was Padme, we'd be happy either way. I agree with Lion. The Danganronpa timeline is a very weird one. Still, I can't believe how much the Mastermind's thoughts and plans you're able to figure out. I didn't have the slightest clue.
Wrong.
In the end, though, I couldn't prove any of it. It was just my reasoning. Essentially, I was making a bet.
Whew.
But it looks like I got it right. This time, at least, I won the bet. She let out a quick sigh. I took it as a small sign of relief. To be honest, I haven't been that nervous in a long time. I totally could not tell you were nervous at all. You seemed totally confident from the moment you decided to go talk to him. Well, presenting a strong demeanor is a fundamental part of negotiation and persuasion, wouldn't you say? Plus, if I show my uneasiness, that would have just made you that much more uneasy. I cannot read. Yeah, you're probably right. Hypothetic.
However,
anyway, we can't relax just yet. All we've done is earn another chance to fight. We have to win this time.
Correct.
Or everything we've gone through would have all been for nothing. If we can't defeat the Mastermind, it'll cost us our lives. There is no option except to win.
Hey.
But before we begin the final battle, we have to tell the others what's going on. True, but now that we know who our enemy is, all we have to do now is work together with everyone to destroy the Mastermind. Work together with everyone?
However,
is that really possible?
Anyway,
right now we have to go find the others.
Shall we go?
They're probably in the dorm somewhere. Shall we go? Gaming, 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 gaming. Boom, boom, boom. Okay. Gaming. Where the gaming? And suddenly, we were greeted with... Sean when you compliment them. You again? Is he broken? I suppose his emotional instability has reached his limit. Oh my god, me? Jeez, what the fuck? Look at Sean.
However,
I wonder what that was all about. Yeah. I couldn't help but let that sigh of relief. Ah!
Is that Makoto?
No.
You guys!
It is! There's no two ways about it. That's Makoto! Huh?
You survived?
Jeez. You're like a stubborn little cockroach, you know that?
I'm just asking to make sure, but you're not a ghost, right?
Hina, my beloved. Everyone was there. All my friends who had struggled together and survived. As soon as I saw their faces, I couldn't help myself. I started to tear up.
What?
Wait. What's that smell?
What the heck?
Yeah, man, that seriously stinks. It's Makoto. He smells like a wet dog. Get away. Shoo. Shoo. And in a flash, my tears dried up. I like how there's like no swearing in the game apart from like Mondo. Yeah, I know. I still can't believe you survived. Yeah, me either. Do you realize why it is you escaped execution? It was Alter Ego. You saved my life.
That's right.
Not too many people can say they had their lives saved by a computer program. I imagine it was a learning experience for you. So what have you guys been doing while I was gone? Well, we figured that since the trial was over, we had have access to new places again. And? No dice. All the rooms that were locked before were still locked. So there weren't near new areas. Main character syndrome. Then where can we go to find new clues? Ugh, you stink. Are you rotten? Rotten physically, mentally, everywhere you can be rotten. Sorry, I was rolling around in garbage for a while. This smell is so smelly. Well, people who can say their lives were saved by a computer program all have our sponsor, NordVPN. Shut the fuck up, Tokyo. She seems happy for some reason.
Yo,
Makoto, what was it like? Makoto, what was it like hanging out in the spirit world? Didn't go to the spirit world.
You know?
Did you get to talk to her? Who?
Hmm.
I don't know who that is. No, I didn't talk to her. I mean, I didn't go to the spirit world. And who the heck is this person? I don't fucking know who it is. Okay.
Makoto.
There's no time to indulge in an extended happy reunion. We need to explain to everyone what happened with Monokuma.
Yes.
Explain? Explain what?
Hmm.
But is it okay that you're here? What if the mastermind catches you?
It's true.
That's related to what I have to tell you all. I need to tell you all about the last class trial.
Huh?
Last class trial?
In other words...
We're going to redo Mukuru's trial.
Huh?
What? Seriously?
How about that?
What's the point of redoing it? Makoto killed her, right? No, I didn't do it. Like I keep telling you.
Wrong.
Makoto isn't the killer, and of course it's not me or any of you. Then who is it?
I see.
What she's saying is it was work of the mastermind.
Huh?
What? You're saying the mastermind killed Mukuro? No fucking shit, bitch.
That's right.
I would love to do that, Rose. That's right. It was all an elaborate trap contrived by the mastermind. Makoto spotted the trap in time and did what he had to do to stop it.
However,
but his decision meant that he would be the one to die.
What?
You
what
spotted
did you
the
say?
Trap? Did you, Makoto? You made it sound like it was easy. I just, you know.
However.
So Spiaki wasn't already in the middle of some double murder to kill Toko in here by the time we got here. I really wish he was. I really wish those two died. But excusing Makoto, who wasn't the Blackened, is a clear violation of school regulations. The rules state that only the Blackened is to be executed. The Mastermind broke their own rules. Which is why I went and negotiated with them to have the trial one more time. Huh? And the Mastermind agreed? Does that mean they really did break the rules? They had no choice but to agree. You used the TV broadcast to gain the leverage you needed, didn't you?
Correct.
Very observant of you.
Naturally.
I recall what you said at the end of the last trial. When you said now it's the Masterminds instead. That's what you're referring to.
Don't be mean.
Hey, I'm totally in the dark here. For anyone who doesn't understand, you can ask Kyoko to explain it again. Later. So, knowing all this, what do we do now?
About that.
It's about who killed Mukuro, right? So our job is to expose the Mastermind? There's more to it than that, correct? Yeah. For us to win this time, we have to solve every last mystery surrounding the school. Every last mystery?
But
we've been looking around all this time, we still don't know anything, right?
Anyway.
You've probably guessed already, but if we lose this time, everyone dies.
Oh,
everyone?
I hate
you. Who said you could agree to those terms without talking to the rest of us? I'm fine with things the way they are. I'm fine with living here forever with my master. I, meanwhile, want to get out of here as soon as humanly possible.
Anyway,
at this point, the only way for us to survive is to unravel the truth. In other words, one decisive final battle. A rather interesting development, I'd say.
But
figuring out who the Mastermind is, and how they killed Mukuro, and the school mysteries, is a pretty tall friggin' order. Maybe, but this time the trial is different. We know who our enemy is now. So if we work together and search as hard as we can, I'm sure we'll all solve those mysteries. I'm not so sure about that.
I
can't agree with the idea of working together with everyone. You can't agree? Why not? The Amakuma just says, well, you solved most mysteries here, but you never solved what my breakfast was last Sunday. One last mystery remains, you all die. I would love that if that were the case. I mean, working together with everyone seems like the most obvious way to solve all the mysteries.
Indeed.
That's what I thought too at first. Until Monokuma gave us the little hint of his. Hint? It's a very polarizing approach. And I know, but okay, enough puns. Anyway, here's a hint. I'm sure I told you this already, but this killing game began with 16 participants, all of them high school students. And the only people to take a single step in Hope's Peak since the killing game began are those 16 students.
I see.
Monokuma said that, did he? Then Kyoko's opinion is perfectly reasonable. Huh? But why?
So in
if the Mastermind really is the one who killed Mukuro, as Kyoko says, then the Mastermind would have had to set foot in the school, right? Monokuma could probably murder Mukuro, but there's no way he could have disguised the scene like that.
In other words,
but according to Monokuma, the only people who have set a foot in Hope's Peak are the 16 students who have been taking part in the killing game. Then the Mastermind is... There are 15 of us in the main hall at the very beginning. Add in Mukuro when you get 16. So the Mastermind would have to be one of them?
That's right.
One of those 16 people. And one of those 16 people we started out with. The only ones still alive are the people standing right here. Need I continue? Or do you get it now? The Mastermind is among us. Oh, fuck. The Mastermind is Leon Kuwata. Just saying, the Mastermind is one of us?
No way!
You can't be serious. Wait, we can't say for sure that's true yet. Monoku might have just said all that to confuse us.
Indeed.
It's certainly a possibility, but only one among many. The Mastermind being one of us is also a possibility. You finished the hole? Sean's been digging a hole on the server. They started it earlier, and it's already done. Literally, a one chunk area dug down to bedrock, including all the deep slate. That must have taken you so fucking long, my god. Shit, Among Us? You coughed the Among Us theme? Of course you did. The Mastermind being one of us is also a possibility. And that is one possibility we can't ignore. Yeah, I mean, they're an ultimate, right? The ultimate despair, so they must be a high schooler. You can't say it's not possible. But if one of us was the mastermind, they'd have to be controlling Monokuma somehow, right? Did you ever see anyone acting suspicious any time Monokuma was active? Well, maybe they snuck off and controlled him in secret.
But
I don't care how sneaky you are. We would have noticed someone sneaking off that many times.
I'm right, right?
Maybe Monokuma was on autopilot. Maybe they loaded up all the dialogue and actions beforehand. In that case, there's no way he could have had all those back and forth conversations with us. Well, it wouldn't be entirely impossible if they directed the flow of the conversation. Well, maybe, but still. We should go to Aqualot and claim the highest peak just in case.
This is a school announcement. You've all probably figured this out by now, but at this point, the killing game has now entered true ending mode.
True ending mode.
So, in the name of fairness, I will unlock every room in the school. Look wherever you want. Solve the mystery in whatever way you see fit. Then we can all meet up at the class trial, okay?
How very magnanimous of him to unlock all the rooms.
That's fine.
The time for talk is done. Now we need to begin our investigation. But I was planning on working alone from the beginning anyway.
In the name of my
At this
family.
Point, I can rely only on myself, on the Sagami blood flowing through my veins. I have no time to worry about the rest of you. Each of you must uphold your responsibility.
Goodbye.
Well then. After making his final statement, Byakuya left the dining hall. With my master. He didn't take me with him?
Hey.
Do you blame him? But like, master, the rest of you are like... I really hate Toko. She's so fucking annoying. Me! So, bye. With that, Toko trudged out of the dining hall. And now she's gone. And you're gonna go off by yourself, right, Kyoko?
Indeed.
That's right. Which just leaves Makoto, Hina, and me.
You know?
In that case, I'm gonna go by myself too.
Just a second.
Wait, how come?
How about
just wait and see. I'm gonna use my totally awesome spirit power to figure out the mastermind's identity. Laughing loudly, Hina left the dining hall. Everyone's really going off by themselves. What about you, Hina? I guess I'll do the same thing.
But
I mean, it's not like I don't trust everyone, you know? But up until now, I haven't really been all that useful. I just depended on Sakura and everyone else. You're not useless. If you hadn't been here, I would have died.
Huh?
Makoto? That's really nice of you to say.
But
still, I know I've mostly been totally useless.
Okay.
So I figure at least here at the end, maybe I can find something that'll help us out or get out of here. So I'm going to go off and do it all my own. Okay, see you later. It was the last time you contributed anything of value. Good point. We all hate it, but admit it, you have fun doing that voice. I don't, actually. Jill? Kinda. But Toko's voice? I mean, actually, yeah, I kind of like doing the voice. It's kind of funny. But as a character, she's really fucking annoying. When I climb the mountain just to spite Ham because I'm evil, remember? Yeah, just as a heads up, Ham fucking blew up Async's house last night. So he can do that back. Jill is always the one who does anything of value. Jill's funny. Hina was in surprisingly high spirits as she dashed out of the dining hall. And once again, it's just us two.
Indeed.
Indeed. It wasn't claimed. So you're going to go off on your own notes here, right, Kyoto?
However.
Well, don't misunderstand. Just because we're going to do our searches separately doesn't mean we can't still work together.
So
that goes for all of us. I think I see what you mean. Doing our own investigations doesn't mean we can't work together in the end. I just see it as splitting up to cover more ground. And then we can get back together and share what we found. Yeah, that's right.
So then,
well, I better get going. I have an endless list of things I need to check.
Correct.
Monokuma said all those doors in the school have been unlocked, right? We should be able to investigate every nook and cranny in the school. We can visit all the places we couldn't go before.
Makoto.
Mikado, no matter what it takes, we have to uncover the truth. By any means necessary. With that, Kyoko was gone. I'm going to start the part where I gave him the TNT to do it. Yeah. Leaving only me. I don't have time to waste either. I have to begin my search. I still can't believe the mastermind might be one of us. This is it, guys. So that's what I have to prove. I'll prove the mastermind isn't one of us. I'll expose the mastermind's true identity and solve the mystery of this school. And then we can all escape together. I guess I'll start by taking another look at Mukuru's Monokuma file. Due to the explosion, the victim's identity is unknown. Actually, yeah, it is a deadly life, because we're investigating Mukuro again. They were, however, dead before the blast. The victim had been stabbed a single time with a knife, which went completely through the body. They'd also been struck in the head with an object about as thick as a metal pipe. The body was covered with other wounds, but these were at least several days old. Once we find out who killed Mukuro Ikusawa, then we'll know who the mastermind is. Can you also say the same thing in... same thing ending, because I'm evil. So where should I start over in my investigation to figure out who killed her? I guess I should start with the rooms that were locked up until now. The headmaster's room, the bio lab, and the door with the data center with Monokuma's face on it. Oh, and the second floor of the dorms, where the gate was down before. That's reopened now, right? After that, I'll have to double check the areas that were connected to the murder, which means the garden and the dojo. Okay, time to get started. The gate's open. We can finally check out the second floor of the dorms. Woo! Which means I have to do it. Oh, this is the second floor of the dorms. So the second floor of the dorms has been completely fucking obliterated. It looks like some ancient ruins. Well, no, it's more like a battlefield, like a bomb blew up here or something. That's a good point. Only a bit of damage. The bed is completely torn apart. I mean, it's not even really a bed anymore. It's just garbage. Yeah, the lights are still on, despite all the damage. This is the girls' bathroom. Even in a place like this, I can't bring myself to go in. Oh my god, a giraffe. This room is filled with lockers. It must have been for the Hope's Peak students who came before us. The class before ours must have used these lockers. The class before theirs. I wonder if I can open this locker. Nope, locked. There's a card reader installed in the door. That must be how you get the locker open. After all, it's pretty similar to the card readers in the locker rooms on the second floor of the school. I have to use your e-handbook to open those up. So does that mean... well, let's just give it a try. Took out my handbook and ran it across the card reader. And then... imagine the biggest clue is inside the bathroom. Makoto just dooms by them all by not going in. Literally. Imagine if that were the case, though. Imagine if there was like a massive clue in one of the bathrooms. We're doing an investigation and literally the bathroom that you don't go into, it just has a fucking massive clue. Oh my god. Like, Makoto, stop being such a fucking sponge. You're doing an investigation. Go in. Maybe only the locker's owner can open it, which means none of us can do it. I wonder if I can open this locker. Nope, locked. Yep. Okay. Come on, Makoto. What's down here? Oh, a door. Door! A locker is locked? Crazy. This room doesn't even feel like a student's room. How does a more adult atmosphere?
Correct.
Is headmaster's private room? Where the fuck do you come from? Kyoko!
Indeed.
I've been through this room several times already, but I still have one little regret. So I decided to check it out one more time. No regret? Kyoko almost looks meek right now. She must be thinking about something. I probably shouldn't bother her. There's a PC on the desk. It must have belonged to the headmaster.
It would seem...
Whoever used this last, it looks like they were very interested in the Ultimate Despair. The PC still has some search results left on it. Do we might be able to get some info on the Ultimate Despair?
However,
there's not much though. Nothing we don't already know.
In other words,
the Ultimate Despair isn't one individual, but instead points to some kind of group. That group is responsible for the tragedy, which happened 1 year ago. They're the worst sorts of people, whose driving force comes from despair.
However,
and that's all there is. Not much to it, is there?
Whew.
But I guess that's the best he could do as a complete kirigiri failure. Any information about the mastermind is helpful, right? I appreciate whatever info we can get our hands on.
Correct.
I see. That's a good outlook to have. Hello, back on PC now. The PC that... Yes, I know.
It would seem...
Huh? There's a strange gap in the wall. Is it some kind of design mistake or a construction defect or something?
So...
There's a gap here. Not just any normal gap. I can feel the breeze coming out. Breeze?
Indeed.
There's likely an open space on the other side of this wall. Does that mean? You mean like a hidden room? I think I might know how to open it. You know how to open it? Did you figure out some kind of trick or something?
Indeed.
Very easy trick, yes. So easy, I'm not sure you can even call it a trick. I saw a program on that PC I think controls it. Enter the right password and the door should open right up.
However.
But I don't have a clue what the password might be. All we know is probably made up of letters and or numbers. We can't really go from there. Right, it's not nearly enough to go on.
It's true.
I looked through all this paperwork, all the files on the PC, everything I could think of. I learned more about him than I ever had any desire to. But nothing that might have been his password.
Whew.
When I think of how much time I've wasted on this... Jeez. So there's a hidden room she couldn't get into. That's what she meant by regret. I think we can assume there must be some kind of... clue waiting in there. Maybe for her. There's more to it than that. Anyway, if we want to get in there, we need to figure out the password. And if Kyoko can't figure it out, no way do I stand a chance. No wait, there might be a chance. The password could be something Kyoko wouldn't have thought of, or something she didn't want to think of. For example, what about your name?
What?
Huh? Sorry, just trying to think of what the password might be. I'm sure she hasn't tried it. I mean, it's totally understandable. That's the way she talked about her dad, the idea that he would use her name as his password. Knowing how she is, I bet the idea never even occurred to her. Do you mind if I try it, just to be sure?
Well?
It's not like you need my permission. If you want to try it, try it. Do whatever you want. Okay. You know, I'm glad I thought of trying Kyoko's name, but if that's not it, I might just hurt Kyoko even more. My essential hey. Watch is past and I associate this room with Hotel Delfino. Of all things. Yes, Haley, I agree. If you're worried about me, Makoto, don't be. I already know that your guess is wrong. In that case, here goes nothing. I collected myself, then turned to face the computer monitor. Let me just type the password here. I typed in her full name. Kyoko Kirigiri. My hands were tense, slightly trembling, and as I finished typing it in, Makoto just casually logs into someone else's secret door account. Makoto be properly hacking. Oh, 100%, Rose, 100%. What? That did it? Kyoko, it worked.
Why?
Kyoko. Without looking at me, she disappeared into the hidden room. She looked grim. Kyoko. Hey, Kyoko. I may as well not have been in this room, but in the room. Her gaze was fixed on only one thing. Present? Wrapped and covered with such joy. That's what made it so unusual? That's what made it so unusual. Actually, non-stop, and they were chased down a lead. Doesn't it matter the whole 100%. The most unrealistic thing about Danganronpa is just a whole room of teenagers actually discussing something sensibly. Dash, oh my god. There's a brightly coloured box here. Seems totally out of place in here. The more I look at it, the more suspicious I get. Should we open it? I'm getting kind of a bad vibe from it. But I mean, we can't not open it. Okay.
Makoto.
Be careful, Makoto. Why, you think it's dangerous? No, not dangerous. But surprising, probably. If it is what I think it is, at the very least, it's not something you'll be happy to see. Wait, so you know what's in there?
Anyway.
Just don't scream or anything, okay? Are you saying it's something that'll make me want to scream? Okay, I'm just gonna open it. Step by heavy step, I approached the box. I took a deep breath, then took hold of the lid. Slowly, ever so slowly, I lifted it up. Light began to sneak its way into the box. I stole a hesitant glance inside and... Kyoko's advice was no use. I let out a trembling cry. Oh fuck! It's Sans! Oh! What was in the box? It was bones. Human bones. It was the last thing I expected to find in such a bright, joyful box. I mean, who could have possibly imagined?
I see.
Just as I thought. Yums, Ned. What? Just as you thought. How could you have known that? I mean, there were bones in there. Human bones!
Wrong.
Well, it's not that I was thinking of the bone specifically. I just had the feeling it would be his body. That's pretty much the same thing. A dead guy in a box. My father. Huh? What about him?
Correct.
What you found in the box? Those bones. That body. That's my father. Kyoko's got a bone to pick with him. Or at least, what's left of him. Are you serious? This is Kyoko's dad? The same man she'd been searching for? Hold on, how can you know that for sure? How do you know that's him?
So,
given all the information we have already, that's the only possible answer. So that same person may very well be the mastermind who planned all this out. And according to the files, the headmaster is a man in his late 30s. It seems possible, even likely, that he's somewhere in this school right now. It's a very polarizing approach, I know, but... Okay, enough plans. Anyway, here's a hint. I'm sure I told you this already, but... This killing game began with 16 participants, all of them high school students. And the only people to take a single step in Hotspeak Academy since the school killing game began are those 16 students. Alter Ego said that the headmaster was probably here in the school, but the only ones who were alive at the start of the killing game were us 16 students. When you put these two ideas together, it doesn't take much to assume.
In other words,
most likely my father was in this school, but he was also dead. That's my assumption, anyway. Wait, I just realised a person executing the starting cutscene of the game. Yeah, so if you guys remember at the very beginning of the game, there's a guy strapped to a rocket and is shot to space. And then their body turns to bones. that skull had a crack in the head because of the impact. Just saying. It got me into like midway into my second playthrough of this game to be like, oh, hang on a fucking minute. I love how the game doesn't actually tell you that. Also, little Easter egg. When Mikoto was in that little garbage dump place, you could see the rocket. The rocket was there. The rocket was there in the garbage dump. The little tip. It was there. As Kyoko explained her analysis, she was completely calm. Well, no, she wasn't calm. She was only trying to seem calm. She said it was just as she thought, so she knew it was a possibility. But I have to believe that at some point she wanted to be proven wrong. Danganronpa becomes Sans. Headmaster shot for the stars. The headmaster really wanted to go to space. It was his lifelong dream to go to space. But I have to believe that at some point she wanted to be proven wrong. Which is why she never looked in the box herself, even though she had plenty of chances. I know Kyoko said she wanted to see her father so she would cut off all ties. But was that all there was to it? I gave up some of that pride. In order to enter Hope's Peak, I had to reveal myself to the school. I did it knowing there was something a true Kirigiri detective would never do. Would she really give up to her pride just for that? I couldn't help but wonder. Huh? This picture. It's all faded. It must be pretty old. Wait, is this a picture of... No. Hey, Kyoko.
Why would you...
Oh, this is annoying. I came here to cut myself free of the past, and yet, then I find something like this? What do you expect me to do now? Then I was right. It's a picture of Kyoko when she was a little girl. Knowing the headmaster had this picture all this time, you must have really cared about her.
Why?
What? I wanted to face him and tell him myself to cut him out of my life for abandoning me. That's the whole reason I came here. And now he's abandoned me again? And this time, he even stole the only opportunity I had to move on. Has there ever been a worse father? Kyoko. Baby Yoko. I feel like I should make pointless small talk right now. Maybe I should just look around a bit first. The headmaster's desk. It's probably hiding some kind of clue, so I really want to check it out, but I really don't want to touch Kyoko's dad's desk without permission.
Hey.
Don't worry about me. Feel free to look around as much as you like. Are you sure?
Because...
Never let anything get in the way of an investigation. I don't. Okay, then if you don't mind. Starting from the top, I opened all the desk drawers and looked inside. I rummaged through each one, finding nothing but unrelated documents. But in the last drawer... Huh? Is this? It's an e-handbook, right? And it has a label on it that says in case of emergency. I found some kind of emergency handbook in the headmaster's desk.
In other words...
A handbook with no limitations, given to the school's ultimate authority, the headmaster. I'm assuming that's what it is. I think you're probably right.
It would seem...
It might prove useful as we continue our investigation. Why don't you hold on to it? No? Oh, but Kyoko.
I
don't need it. If you don't want it, go ahead and leave it here. Then, I guess I'll take it. Is it really okay? Just think in the way, especially not the freaking bathroom.
Hey.
Makoto was such a fucking sponge. Listen, Makoto. Huh? Can I ask you a favor? What is it?
So...
I know it's completely unreasonable to ask you this. I know it only can inconvenience you that much more, but
hey,
could you leave? Huh?
Correct.
Just for a little while. I'd just like to be alone for a bit. Kyoko, don't worry, I'm fine. I just need to calm down a little. I need to get just my emotions in order. You know, Kyoko, you told me before about the relationship you had with your dad. Are you only connected by blood, not by heart and soul? But maybe that picture motivated him. Maybe he'd hope to see me again someday. Is that what you're going to say? If so, that's just a theory. Not a game theory. And this isn't an issue that can be settled with theories. That picture doesn't change the facts of what happened, what I went through.
I...
That problem can't be solved so easily. You're right. I'm sorry.
Anyway...
Once I've got myself under control, I'll return to the investigation immediately. So please, just give me some time to myself. Okay, I understand. Then I'll see you later. It's so sad. Is she really okay? Kyoko, it must have been a complete shock to her. I mean, it was a shock to me. To find out what happened to her, the headmaster. There's no doubt that the mastermind performed that evil deed. They killed the headmaster, killed Kyoko's father. They killed him. The headmaster is dead. The one leading the Hope's Peak staff, the one who finalized the plan to isolate you, was the Hope's Peak headmaster. So that same person may very well be the mastermind who planned the site. And according to the files, the headmaster is a man in his late 30s. It seems possible, even likely, that he's somewhere in this school right now. But we were wrong about that. The headmaster wasn't the mastermind. Which means the mastermind's true identity is... It's a very polarizing approach, I know, but... Okay, enough puns. Anyway, here's a hint. I'm sure I've told you this already, but this kind of game began with 16 participants, all of them high school students. And the only people to take the single step at Hope's Peak since the killing game began are those 16 students. So just while Sansa the capitalized S, it just becomes the emote. Her dad became Sans Undertale. Yeah, I know. There's typically a lot of flashbacks, which I never really noticed until like the fifth time round. 15 of us met in the main hall, add new crew to the mix, and you get 16. And including me, only 6 of us are still alive. Everyone else is dead. Leon! Even Mukuro. Even she's undeniably dead. So the ones still left alive are... me. Byakuya. Hiro. Toko. Hina. And Kyoko. Only those 6 people are left alive. Then there's no question. Wait, no, that can't be. I refuse to believe there has to be some other way. There just has to be. And your mother? I wonder if I can open this locker. Nope, locked. No luck. Maybe only the locker's owner can open it, which means none of us can do it. Wait, but what about the emergency handbook I found in the headmaster's hidden room? Okay, let's give it one more try. So the emergency handbook ran across the card reader and beep. Alright, just what I was hoping for. Let's see what we've got inside. This locker is totally disorganized. Whoever it belonged to is probably has organization problems in every part of their life. This is a crystal ball? A crystal ball? No, it can't be. There's no way he ever used this locker. It's just not possible. Leon's locker. Don't say there might be a clue. It's a Leon reference. This thing is practically empty. That's just one thing. Some kind of pocketbook. I don't see a name written on it, so I can't say for sure whose it is. But there's some writing inside. It could be important. I don't like violating the owner's privacy, but I'd better take a look. Leon's crystal ball. It took me a moment. Oh yeah, Leon used a crystal ball, didn't he? I didn't remember that. Even though I played through this game like 5 fucking times. It looks like a girl's handwriting. And all the letters are spaced out evenly, like whoever wrote them was measuring them. Whoever wrote this must have been pretty meticulous. Huh? I was flipping through the pocketbook, but my hand froze when I got to a certain page. I saw something familiar written there. Words I've heard before. Good screenshot. There's a plan to turn Hub's Peak into a shelter and isolate the students here in a communal life. I decided to talk to the one who came up with the plan directly. It just so happens to be the headmaster and my father. He was willing to give me some more details regarding the plan. Here's what he said. The point is to keep our student prodigies safe, to keep them as our hope for the future. Only their genius can overcome disaster, and only their hope can overcome despair. For the future of our country, our world, it's not an exaggeration to call this our final hope. We must isolate our superior youth from the corrupted world to serve as the foundation for a new era. This is the only hope we have. I hope that you'll all be willing to go along with this plan. That's what my father had to say to me. As usual, he made a selfish decision without consulting anyone else. I can't imagine a worse father. This can't be true, can it? I knew it was. I knew exactly who the pocketbook belonged to. Kyoko. It couldn't be anyone else. But if this belongs to Kyoko, then what was it doing in this locker? And what she wrote here completely contradicts what she already told me. She said she hasn't seen the dad since he left when she was little. I decided to talk to the one who came up with the plan directly. It just so happened to be the headmaster and my father. What does this all mean? I quickly scanned the remaining pages of the notebook. Must have been looking for something that would prove me wrong about this whole thing. But when I reached the last page, the question mark spinning through my mind just started spinning that much faster. When I looked at it, and like the rest of the pocketbook was writing here, it was messy, disorganized, scrawled. Did you guys see? It said Among Us. Is he going to show it again? I have no idea. How could this possibility make any sense? That's the pocketbook. Okay. Can I show it? Can I show it? It fucking said Among Us, guys. Despair walks among us, and so we survive. There's a second despair. Kyoko said Among Us! Among Us, guys! She said Among Us! Guys, this is an Among Us moment. The board even cuts off after the A. Among Us. Despair walk. Spare walks Among Us. Fucking hell. We are so fucked up in the head, I swear. There's nothing else in here, Makoto. There is literally nothing else in here. Oh yeah, same. Despair walks among us. There's all kinds of textbooks and notebooks stacked up in no particular order. And dust everywhere. I have to assume whoever's stuff this is didn't do a lot of studying. Not that I can really talk, trying to act as casual and natural as possible. I picked up one of the notebooks I saw. But the moment I looked inside the notebook, any sense of easiness I may have had evaporated. What? Yasuhiro Hagakure. There was no denying what I saw. Inside the notebook was written Yasuhiro Hagakure. Is this our Yasuhiro? My notebook also contains a large number of notes for a variety of different classes. Yasuhiro Leon? Which would mean he attended classes here? That can't be possible. I mean, Hiro came to this school at the same time as the rest of us. And we were all sucked into this evil world. We never had the chance to take any classes. So what is this notebook? The more I see, the less it makes sense. Because these lockers, I mean, they had to belong to the previous students, right? So why am I seeing this? Why are the things in the lockers that look like they belong to people here? Everyone is Leon. A notebook that seems like it belongs to Hiro? A pocketbook that seems like it belongs to Kyoko? There has to be some kind of explanation. But if I want to find that out, I have to keep moving the investigation forward. I have to believe in everyone. Okay, let's fuck off, Makoto. We've seen everything we can up here. Okay. Oh yeah, also guys, once I'm done with this game, if we have time, I might just like show off the Hope's Peak build on the Minecraft server that I've been doing. And by doing, I haven't made any progress on it in like a year. But it could be nice to show off at least. Tato Danga, that'd be Pog. Bam 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 da da bam 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 bam.
Hey Makoto!
Ah, Makoto, you here to look around too? Is that what you're doing here? Mm. Yeah, I can't help but wonder about the Monokuma door. Yeah, it's on season 2, but I've also put it on the season 3 hub world.
Yeah!
So I figured if all the doors in the school have been unlocked, that one should open too, right?
But...
although I can't bring myself to open it. Because it might explode, right? That'd really suck. So, you open it. I'm sure she didn't mean it, but she made it sound like she was only okay with me getting blown up. Unless he wouldn't mind doing something like that. Like, I just write a case, someone gets on board, tries to kill and the rest solve it. Like, that could be really fun. It's just a case of actually doing it. I don't know. Okay, so I guess I'll open it. Ah, wait, let me take over first. I don't want to get exploded. He notices a nearby desk and hid underneath it. Okay, go ahead. Everything will be okay, right? Alright, here goes nothing. I threw all my weight into it, but the door opened much easier than I expected. There was no explosion, thankfully. My first impression was...
huh?
What? This place is totally sci-fi. I was thinking the same thing. The fuck? You can give it a big shot. What is this device? Looks like some kind of control panel. It's really over the top though, like some kind of military installation or something.
Hmm.
It kind of looks like a mech cockpit, right? If you would probably freak out if you saw it. Cockpit? So the Monokuma room has a control panel that looks like some kind of cockpit. Yeah, it's difficult. Then could that mean...
okay.
Wait, let's stop poking it or whatever. I'm going to start pushing buttons. Hold on, you can't just... oh, whatever, something like this. But it was too late. Hina's already jabbing away at the control panel.
Huh?
Hmm? Did you hit that? Yeah, I think from the other room. Hina, what did you push? I'm not totally sure, but I think it was that one. The one that says data center? Data center? Took a good look at the control panel. And I saw a bunch of buttons, each with the name of a room next to it. And just like Hina said, there was one labeled data center. That must be the one she pushed. But the data center... that's right next door. The room we're just in, that's where the strange noise came from. I'll probably better go check it out.
Yeah.
Yes, please. I'm kind of scared out of my mind right now, so I'll just cheer you on from over here. I guess so. Did I just hear what I think I heard? Is that Monokuma? Hey! Give me all your donuts! Is that you, Hina? What? Oh man, busted. How did you know?
Say what?
Anyway, what is this? Some kind of remote control camera kind of setup? I don't even know what you're controlling?
Hello.
Well, I mean, I can't really say anything from in here.
Found it!
Ah, guess what I found? A self-destruct button! Whatever you do, don't push it!
Too bad!
Oh man. Were you seriously gonna push it? You know, I guess that settles it. The room with the Monokuma drawing on it and the control panel inside. A very clear, distinct voice. I talk high pitched and all like annoying sounding. Whoa, hey Makoto, what the heck was that just now? In the flesh. Monokuma?
Huh?
What do you mean? What you were controlling just now, it was Monokuma.
Huh?
Monokuma? For real? Yep, look at the panel, definitely controls Monokuma. She's the mastermind and has been controlling Monokuma from this room. They were definitely in here. The mastermind has been controlling Monokuma from this room. And this control room is totally separate from the data center area with all the monitors. In other words,
hey,
maybe the mastermind can't monitor us and control Monokuma at the same time. Kyoko's theory was right.
But
if the mastermind's been controlling Monokuma from here, that means they've been inside the school the whole time, right? I guess that'd have to be true. But if that is true... Make that 5 times, Ham. Anyway, here's a hint. I'm sure I've told you this already, but this kidding game began with 16 participants, all of them high school students. And the only people to ever take a single step inside Hope's Peak since the kidding game began are those 16 students. The game does a lot of backtracking, but just to make sure you actually do memorize it, I guess. The mastermind, Monokuma's puppeteer, really is a 16th student? It can't be. There's no way, right? Yeah, I really have a problem with it. It does kind of make sense to keep reminding you about certain things. But especially seeing as it's really important. It's a big key that you need to memorize. So I guess it makes sense. It keeps on like reminding you. What's wrong, Makoto? I don't like the face you're making. Like Monokuma said. Oh no, it's nothing. Okay. What about you? Is everything okay? It's just... This is where the mastermind's been hiding, right? Who knows if they set up traps or something? I can't say it is impossible. But I really hope it's not true. You want to leave soon? There's still lots of other places to check out. Yeah, good point. We can't waste all our time standing around here. Okay, you want to get going? Yeah. As soon as the door to the data center was closed, I heard a strange sound. What was that? It just locked on its own? What? My hand shot to grab the doorknob. No, it's locked, but why? Of course it's locked! The data center is now restricted. Monokuma?
Just a
no fair. You can't just go around restricting whenever you feel like.
Hey,
it's for your benefit! Because if that room stays open, I won't be able to move around. Imagine how depressed everyone would get if the school mascot just up and stopped moving. In that room.
Yep.
As you may have guessed, that's where my controls are. So right now you're being operated by someone in that room.
Yes, indeed.
Correct, Amundo.
You're a liar.
Doesn't make any sense. We were just in there and didn't see anyone. Oh, you didn't, did you? Are you sure you were as thorough as you could have been? Did you happen to check a certain suspicious vent? Do you see the small vent on the floor? Bum 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 bum. No way! patch on the floor? The vent on the floor. Too bad, that was your one big chance, and you blew it.
Too bad.
Of course, the hatch can't be open from the outside anyway, so whatever. I'm not pulling a lippy. Now then, this room is officially restricted, so no more investigating. I'll be relying on you guys to tell the others. Peace. He's gone, but...
So,
was he really telling the truth? The mastermind was hiding in there? In fact, if you think back to when we got locked out of the control room, that proves it for sure. Then, when I said we should leave, well, the hatch couldn't be open from the outside anyway, right? It's not your fault.
Sorry.
Anyway, we don't have to let it get to us. We have to stay positive and make the most of the time we have left. You're right. If there's one thing I'm good at, it's keeping my body moving.
Okay.
I'm gonna go run around to tell everyone what you found here. Nice. You got me all motivated again.
You got it.
Okay, I might see you later. And I have to do what I can too. That's the only way forward. This third master's room. I've heard an awful lot about it, but this will be my first time seeing it for myself. Ah, Makoto, it's you. Oh, Byakko. Nope. Well, you came to the right place this time. Would you like to see something interesting? What do you mean, something interesting? Take a look at this. It says class number 78, student roster. You can't see because my big head's in the way. It was not with that pathetically ostentatious desk. Class 78, student registry? I mean, it's a student roster, but that works too. It contains profiles for all of us. And Mukuro.
So in
apparently
words,
class 78 refers to us. Wait, when we found Mukuro's profile in Kyoko's room?
I see.
That's right, it also mentioned class 78. This must be where Kyoko got the page. And since the rest of our profiles are listed in here, along with hers,
in other words,
there can be no doubt, Mukuro was a student here at Hope's Peak Academy, just like the rest of us. Mukuro Ikusaba, the 16th student, laying hidden somewhere in this school. The one they call the Ultimate Despair. Watch out for her. That must be how Kyoko learned about it. But it seems that Kyoko was in a hurry. What do you mean? I'm talking about when she stole it. The uneven tearing, the way the paper had been crumpled. She must have been in a hurry. Well, since she snuck in to get it, I'm sure she wanted to get out as fast as possible. What's your point? She was in so much of a hurry that she only got the first page. First page? Correct. Mukuro's profile actually contains two pages.
So in other words,
when it comes to this profile, there was more information about Mukuro than we still didn't have. What kind of information is it? Why do you ask me to explain every little thing? You can read, can't you? Seems to be some sort of detailed report put together by the headmaster himself. I don't know what kind of man he was, but I'm glad he left us such an interesting clue. I was half listening to Byakko as I skimmed through the report. Mukuro reappeared suddenly, and in the background an entity floats, close but just out of reach. The entity known as the Ultimate Despair. Right now, I can't be sure if this is a single person or some kind of group. Whatever it is, Mukuro definitely has some sort of connection to it. I have a bad feeling about all this. I need to push forward with my research into the Ultimate Despair. I need to pay attention to Mukuro's behaviour too. This is just my gut feeling, but I think she's dangerous. Despite the countless battles she must have gone through as a member of Fenrir, when she entered Hope's Peak, she didn't display any signs of battle wounds or scars. That fact alone proves her tremendous skill in battle. Naturally, I want to believe in her. She's one of my students, after all. But if I decide she's a danger to the other students, I will be forced to take all reasonable measures. Mukuro was a part of the Ultimate Despair. I don't think there can be any doubt about it now. But wouldn't that mean Mukuro and the Mastermind were allies? So why would they kill Mukuro? Plus, even the Headmaster seemed to be afraid of what Mukuro was capable of. They would have had to take her completely by surprise to kill her like that. Maybe it means the Mastermind is even stronger than Mukuro was.
What?
What's wrong, Makoto? Huh? You seem to be lost in thought. But I should probably point out one other thing. There's another port of information within that file that you should note. What is it? Did you notice the picture in there? A picture of a girl perhaps you've never seen before? A girl who seems to be included as part of our class 78? That should be enough for you to figure out who the girl is. I mean, it literally says Mukuro Ikusaba next to the picture. You can't see because I'm in the way, but it literally says Mukuro Ikusaba. And further information about that girl is included in the file. It's 5 foot, 7 inches, 97 pounds, and even lists her vitals. 31, 22, 32. Well, what do you think? What do you think? Are you asking me, like, if she has a nice body? You hopeless idiot. What I'm trying to tell you is maybe you want to keep that in mind for later. Maybe you'll make your way back to the corpse, and maybe you'll think, oh, could that mean? Wait, is he trying to say... There's a chance the body isn't actually Mukuro? Is that what he's saying? Personally, what I'm thinking seems all but impossible. But it wouldn't hurt to confirm, right?
It's all clear.
That's all I was trying to say. What you do with that information is your business. So I'm about to be in Byaki's errand, boy. Interesting. How very interesting. Oh, and one last thing. It's a bit of advice from me to you, so I suggest you pay attention. Advice for me? You seem to be getting along with Kyoka quite well. It's not really getting along, we've just done a lot to help me. Well, don't put too much faith in her.
In other words,
the cost of that faith might be more than you can afford. What are you saying? It's what I think. Go on to a hunch. A hunch? But my hunches tend to be proven right. The advice is free this time. Take it or don't, as you will. Keep it in mind. Thanks. Interesting. How very interesting. Toko, this is where you are.
What do you want?
Am I so disgusting you want me out of your sight? It's not it at all, I just thought maybe you'd find a clue. Well, I haven't. I didn't find anything, not one single clue. I figured since this place was related to the case, I would have found something, right? But there wasn't anything out of the ordinary here. Haley? I was supposed to actually disable that for this stream. I can't really do that with Danganronpa. It kind of defeats the point. However, I will make a note, alright? The next time you're in a Minecraft stream, I will do it for free. I mean, you've already paid. You've already paid for that thing, but I mean, I can't really do it right down the Danganronpa stream. Sorry. I will remove the point rewards for now. But I will make a note to do it the next Minecraft stream that you're in. When you're there, remind me to do it. I'll remove that one, that one, that one, and that one. Okay. What's wrong with the sound smash? It kind of just... It makes the audio sound shit, and it takes things away. I want to focus on the game, not the sound smash. Usually the pissing around streams are the Minecraft ones. The Danganronpa ones, we're fucking doing this shit. But no, I will do it on the Minecraft stream. Should be tomorrow. But there's anything out of the ordinary here. Give it back. Give me back my precious time. Calm down, Togo. Fucking hell, what is your fucking problem, bitch? Don't tell me to calm down. Do you have any idea what I'm going through right now? When everyone finds out, they're going to call me useless. Good for nothing. Nobody's going to say that. Master will. I'm not sure I can disagree with that. I don't want that. I'm sick of always being looked down on. Why won't anyone accept me? Well, I don't think there are any clues here, so maybe I'm just going to get going. We found a clue in here, but it was just the mouse from his head. Frank Kogel. Huh? It's gone. Mukuru's body. It's not here? There are still just the four chickens left. Honestly, I'd be kind of terrified if there were more than that. Maybe this body's inside the tool shed? Better check just to be sure. I didn't find anything even close to a dead body. Leon stole the body. Oh fuck. But if it's not in here either, then it must be... I have no idea where. The corpse is not the only thing that I need to check in here. There is one other thing. The tarp. The tarp played a key role in another case, so I better look into it. The killer used the tarp to heat the sprinklers from getting the body wet. Which means the killer might have left some clue behind here. Huh? I didn't notice this before. But there's a small stamp on one corner of the tarp. It says Biolab. It says Biolab. Yeah, I just said that. Then this originally came from the Biolab? Hey Toshi! You've missed so much. I can't even fill you in this time. The fifth chicken with Leon in disguise, obviously. Yeah, you're a little bit late. 2 hours. I mean, I can try filling you in on what you missed. It's still fun to watch. I mean, I can fill you in on some of the things. Basically, what's going on is we're redoing Mukuro's trial. But the catch this time is that, yeah, we know it's the mastermind who killed Mukuro. So this case is literally a case of finding out who the mastermind is. So we have to uncover all the mysteries of the school and who killed Mukuro. If we do that, we win. If we don't, we all die. So we're investigating every single room in the school. Hey, saying Splatoon guys, arrived to talk about Splatoon, nothing else at all. In a Danganronpa stream, please don't. You can do it in the Minecraft stream, just not the Danganronpa. Could our body have gone? I better start looking for it. Well, here I am in the biolab. It's so cold. It's like abnormally cold. I feel like I'm in a giant refrigerator. Seriously, why is it so cold? The stack of tarps here. I've been seeing a lot of those things lately. There's some kind of weird machine or something built onto the wall. On the left side, there's a bunch of glowing blue lights. But on the other side... Ah, hang on. I've seen something like this before. Ah, that's it. I've seen this kind of thing in horror movies and stuff. It's a fridge for storing dead bodies. Does that mean this biolab's actually a morgue? I should probably take a closer look around. Oh, fuck. I'm skipping through things I'm thinking of. There's some kind of weird machine on the wall. Built into the wall. On the left side, there's a bunch of glowing blue lights. Only some of them are on. The ones on the left? The right-hand lights are off. I'll read that again because I was a mess. There's some kind of weird machine or something built into the wall. And on the left side, there's a bunch of glowing blue lights. But only some of the lights are on. The ones on the left? The right-hand lights are off. Oh, there's some kind of book here. It looks like an instruction manual. We offer an eco-friendly alternative to standard dry ice for your cadaver needs. In addition to the germicidal lamps, we also provide an ozone generator for the removal of ethylene gas. Simply insert the cadaver, and the blue light will let you know the automated systems have activated. Hang on. Temperatures and humidity levels will be adjusted automatically for optimum settings. With our system, anyone can keep a body fresh for a daisy. As a daisy for as long as you need. In the unlikely event of a problem, the red light will activate and an alarm will sound immediately. The exterior is stainless steel, and we do offer an optional leather upholstery upgrade package. This is the instruction manual for the fridge. Looking around, I think I get it. Seems clear to me now. Some kind of makeshift morgue. Is that 9 lights on? And about those lights by each slot? It looks like we're set up so when a slot is occupied, the blue light comes on. Which would mean inside each slot lit up is blue. Another one of the victims is... I can't let my emotions take control right now. There's only one thing I can do for everyone who's died, and that's defeat the mastermind. And to do that, I have to continue my investigation. I don't have any other option. That is indeed 9 lights. Yes. That is indeed 9 lights. Diddle-a-dum, diddle-a-dum.
Announcement. Is everyone working hard? Is your investigation coming along nicely? Well then, since you're all giving it your best, your generous headmaster will give you a little hint. For those of you who are interested, please make your way to the gym ASAP possible.
What? Now he wants to give us a hint? It's suspicious. There's no doubt about that. This could be a trap. But even knowing that... You said to go to the gym, right? Ten are dead. Some recruiters must be somewhere else, I assume. Oh. Hey, hero. Mikoto? Why are you so surprised? No reason. Oh shit, the Leon motive. You heard Monokuma's announcement, right? Are you here to find out what he has to say? I just did actually. I'm on my way out. You told him what he say? Listen, sorry, but I gotta go! Here, wait! There's no point in trying to stop him. He ran off like a frightened animal. Okay, that makes no sense then. Welcome to Danganronpa. It would all make sense in the end. Kiro? He's trying to avoid me. All I will say, username is everything will make actual sense in the end. He was like he was trying to avoid me. I was hoping to talk to him about the notebook I found in the locker. Has he been hiding something this whole time? Haven't done that in a while.
I am Monokuma!
Hello, welcome, welcome, hello, are you ready for your final hint? Well, it just so happens to be in the envelope on the ground in front of you. Really, everything, Libby? Everything will make sense. The envelope? This must be the envelope. I mean, that does make sense. That's just the art style. And just so you know, I won't be answering any questions about what you find inside. They're just very distinguished. Don't worry, just get on with it. Monokuma's crypto works didn't make me feel any better, so I picked up the envelope. And opened it. What I found was a single photograph. It featured a bunch of faces I recognize extremely well. It was everyone who comes to Hope's Peak at the same time as me. Also, Leon is in there. Leon is there. Guys, Leon. Wait, but there's someone behind Sayaka. Holy shit, Leon. She's the one I don't recognize. So I do recognize her. That's right, when Byakura and I were in the headmaster's room and we looked at that file. Mukuroi Kusaba? Oh my god, it's him! Leon! And he's got his arm around Sayaka. And this girl is... What? Why? Why is Mukuro here with everyone else? And even more than that... Just having everyone here pose like this is weird enough by itself. We were wearing matching uniforms, I don't remember anything like this. And now that I'm looking at it, it's not even everyone. I'm not in the picture. I'm the only one not there. The picture has all 15 other students, but not me. But I guess that makes sense. I don't remember ever taking a picture like this. I went to junior high with Sayaka, but that's the first time I met everyone else. Was when I arrived here at Hope's Peak Academy. So it's natural for me to not be in this picture, but what's definitely unnatural is that everyone else is in the picture. Makoto, you probably took the picture. I mean, do you see Fumi? He's holding a camera. They're probably just doing it in front of a mirror. I thought everyone was like me and didn't know each other until they got here. But this picture is real. And could that mean... Could it be everyone else and just me? Everyone here except me is... How long are you going to keep at this rambling soliloquy of yours, Hamlet? You're kind of getting in the way standing there, you know? So I mean, get out! But I told you, I'm not fielding any questions. What kind of mystery would this be if I gave you the answers? That'd be totally out of left field. Guess that means he's done talking. Damn it. So in the end, all I found at the gym was even more confusion. Ifumi was taking a picture of Makoto. And with that confusion in hand, I left the gym dejected. Thought it was a phone he was using to watch Princess Piggles. It might be. I wouldn't put that past him. How does that count as a hint? It just made me even more confused. Is that what Monokuma was going for? Did he put together a fake photo just to confuse me? But it looks so real, so full of life. How could anyone fake that? Yeah, that's the completely fictional anime that Hifumi, like, is a huge fan of and does not shut the fuck up about. Which I mean, everyone but me? Maybe just ask everyone directly. That should clear all this up. No, I have to clear all this up. Oh yeah, you know everything there is to know about Hifumi. He's a very special character. I decided to visit the biolab one more time. You seem just a mod on your server, so you must just be Ifumi IRL. Maybe. We don't know what username looks like, so just saying, they could be Ifumi. and decided to appear at the bio lab one more time. I'm sorry, username. Please don't take that as an insult. I'm sorry. And the first thing I saw when I got there was her passed out again. Only passed out? Huh? Toko? Toko, are you okay? No. She's not dead, is she? Fucking hope so. What? It's cold. It's super cold. It's cold like... I might catch cold. Oh no, cardboard cut out, Toko. Holy shit, Toko is fucking dead. If you keep taking naps in places like this, I'm sure you will. What? I was asleep? I must have fainted again. I bet you were standing there staring at me, getting all excited, weren't you? Shut up. No, I wasn't. Oh? Then what? Hot and bothered? Okay, so what did you pass out? Hey Isaac, how you doing? What a shame. I don't know, last thing I remember was me waking up that just now. So what did you do to Miss Morose? Miss Morose. Oh, that's right, your memory stops and starts each time you switch. Bingo bazinga! We share some basic knowledge, but our memories are very much separate. I don't say it like it's some bad thing, it's a blessing as far as I'm concerned. Because even if she forgets something, I totally remember. So it's like double the memory. No, it's more like half. But all I want to... I can't talk. But all I want to... I'm going to get a drink, guys, okay? My voice, it's dying on me. I'm going to get a drink. I'll switch to my camera. I'll literally be right there. Okay. Hydration. Hydration. I'm thirsty, okay? My voice is dying and I need hydration. Without knocking my bottle over. It's fine. I'll live. Actually, I cannot talk. Water. Gaming, okay. Hydrate or die straight. We don't want that. Okay. Let's do this. But all I want to know right now is where's my little darling? Tell me now or I'll slit your throat. High lion stands for hydrated lion. That makes two of us. I don't know. I'm sure Biaki's around here somewhere doing his own investigating. Yes, by himself? Yes. I assume so. I knew it. I totally knew it. I'm a total pro when it comes to all things master. Shut up. Hydration. Anyway, I gotta hurry. Can't imagine how lonely he must be right now. Oh, Toko. Please change. Toko shot off, her eerie laughter echoing behind her. Ah, I totally forgot to ask about the picture. Well, there's no point in asking Genocide Jack anyway. Besides, I have more important things to do right now. Why did Toko faint? There's gonna be some reason for it. The fridge is open. But I'm sure they were all shut tight last time I was here. That must be why she passed out.
Right.
She faints so easily. Kyoko?
Makoto.
It's getting late, isn't it? 100% lying. He does. Are you okay?
Indeed.
I'm sorry if I made you worry. No, you'd have to apologize.
Listen.
But listen, about this room. Yeah, it's... It's a morgue. Yeah.
I knew it.
I suspected as much. And Toko must have looked inside the fridge, seen what was in there, and well, there you have it. You knew she'd fainted?
Indeed.
I was on my way here when Genocide Jack came running past me. I assumed she must have sneezed, but once I got inside, the real reason became clear.
It would seem...
I imagine she came here to investigate, and when she opened the slot there, that's when she saw the body inside and dropped like a bag of rocks. Why is everything going to be so difficult with her? Anyway, we should close it up. Don't want to leave it hanging open like that. Yeah, good idea.
Makoto.
Give me a hand with this. Kyoko approached the fridge, hands outstretched. Suddenly she stopped. What's wrong?
Listen.
Maybe we should wait a second before closing it. Huh? How come? Because Mukuro's body is in here. Mukuro's corpse? Mukuro's body's inside the fridge?
I see.
Just like every other time, the mastermind probably brought it up here when we were in the class trial. The mastermind did it? Because they assumed we wouldn't be doing the class trial over again, I guess.
So...
You may be right. Either way, now I can finally get a good look at the body. Oh, that's right. Kyoko didn't get a chance to check the body during the last investigation.
Makoto.
I need to do my own examination of the corpse as soon as possible. I'm going to find a clue this time, and I'm going to grab the mastermind by the tail. Okay, so what should I do?
So then...
Why don't you just wait over there? I'll let you know as soon as I'm finished. Okay, so Mukuro's here. I mean, that hasn't been confirmed. She's going to investigate the corpse now. You know, I think I've seen the top of this one before. Ah, it's the same as the one I found in the garden tool shed. If you remember that tarp. I had a stamp on it that said Biolab. I get reactions. Oh my god. They're just number one rated salesman 1997 speak. My god, they predicted Spamton G. Spamton in 2010. And that's just the tarp that was used to help camouflage the murder in the garden. At some point, someone got it from the Biolab and took it over here. A bunch of blue lights are on. But these ones aren't. You've seen the blue light comes on when a slot is occupied. So when someone's in there, the blue light comes on. Looking around, the number of lights that are on, including Mukuro's, there's 9 in all. 9? 9 lights? Leon's still alive. I knew it. Oh no, Leon. It's a fridge meant for storing dead bodies. I can't look inside. I should ask Kyoko about that group photo. At all, she's in it too. Don't let me interrupt your investigation, but I wanted to talk to you about something. What is it? It's about that announcement Monokuma made earlier. You mean the one about a hint or something? I didn't take him up on the offer. Huh? Why not?
Because
the only reason he'd give us a hint at this point would be to confuse us, to cloud our judgment. I can solve this mystery on my own, without whatever hints he may have to offer. Leon's death became the mastermind. That's a good point. I wish I could go back and do the same thing, but what's done is done, I guess. Standing here looking at her, I don't think she's hiding anything from me. Is she right? Did the mastermind forge that picture as a trap to confuse us? Oh, so we can just sit in the room uninterrupted. That's gotta be it. There's no other explanation. Okay, Makoto, I'm done. Already? Jeez, that was fast.
Indeed.
Anyone could do good work if they go slow. In that spirit, I make my report brief. So did you find anything?
Indeed.
I paid careful attention to the wounds and traces of blood, and it seems likely that the stomach wound and the blow to the back of the head were inflicted after death. Really? 100%. 100%, and I love it. The burnt tissue made things a little difficult, but I'm completely confident in my findings. So that means neither of those were the fatal injury, right? Then what was the fatal injury? Due to the explosion, the victim's identity is unknown. They were, however, dead before the blast. The victim had been stabbed a single time with a knife, which went completely through the body. They'd also been struck in the head with an object about as thick as a metal pipe. The body was covered with other wounds, but these were at least several days old. The only other option is those other wounds, but the file says they were old.
Is that right?
Why does it say they were old? Huh?
Because
all the Monokuma file says is that they were infected at least several days ago. I guess I don't see the difference.
Wrong.
Well, the difference is immense, considering the impression they give.
Listen.
You seem to be equating several days old with simply old.
However,
but that doesn't quite flow logically. Old wounds would make it sound like they've been there forever, like they're not related to the murder. Are you saying they are? All we got for the Monokuma file. But we all got the Monokuma file right after she was killed, right? So the wounds were at least several days old. There was no way they would have anything to do with it.
So then.
But if Mukuro herself wasn't killed within the last few days? What?
At the very least.
Certainly, you can allow it as one of the many possibilities, can you?
Right.
A detective doesn't have supernatural powers. There's no way to predict the answer from the beginning. Instead, the ideal detective begins by imagining as many possible scenarios as they can.
In other words,
they envision these possibilities without prejudice, without bias, using only their logic and common sense. Then as they investigate, they test what they find against each other's possibilities. Of course, me telling you this doesn't mean you'll be any good at detective work, but beyond using that to solve this particular mystery, you should keep this in mind for later. In for future. Okay, Pog. Salary cutting noises.
Hey.
So if there's anything else you'd like to know about the condition of the body, now's the time. Come to think of it, there was one thing. Earlier when I was looking at Mukuro's profile, it listed her height and weight.
So
5 foot, 7 inches, 97 pounds. Vitals were 31, 22, 32. Did I get that right? You remembered all that? They are indeed consistent with the corpse. So then,
indeed.
And don't forget about the Fenrir tattoo, there's absolutely no mistake.
Indeed.
Our victim in this case is, without a doubt, Mukuro Ikusaba.
And?
Is that all you wanted to ask? Yeah, I think so.
So then.
It looks like we have no further business with Mukuro's body. Let's get going. It's kind of chilly in here. We're not going to put the body back? Do you think it's kind of sad leaving out like this?
Why?
Sad? Did you forget? She was our enemy once. A part of the ultimate despair. But she's not killed, she's still a victim.
Hey.
Have you ever heard the phrase, you reap what you sow? Yeah, but still. You really are naive, you know that? It's really quite appalling. But she could have abandoned me, but she decided to help me instead. So for someone like that, what does it mean to be naive?
So then.
I think we've done all we can do here. Back to our separate investigations, yes? Hold on. I still have one more thing to do. Something we need to talk to Kyoko about. I need to ask about the pocketbook I found in that locker. If I don't do it now... Hey, Kyoko. I did have one last thing. I know I shouldn't, but I feel like I have to ask.
What?
Go ahead then, out with it. Have you really not seen your dad even once since you got here? Because you little sponge, do you want a police investigation that's underway this based on a real story mystery? How long did that take you to write?
What?
What?
So...
What do you mean? Well, you know all those lockers on the second floor of the dorms?
Indeed.
I do, yes. But to get to any of those lockers, you need the handbook of whoever the locker belongs to. Actually, I managed to get them open using that emergency handbook.
I see.
The one you found in the headmaster's hidden room.
And?
So, did you find anything worthwhile in the lockers? I found a pocketbook, and after looking through it, I think it must be your pocketbook.
Why is that?
What makes you say that?
Because...
Like I said, only the locker's owner should be able to get into it, right? I can't imagine those lockers belong to any of us. After all, we only got access to the area just recently. What I'm saying is there's no way I could have had access to any of those lockers. And if I did have a pocketbook, why would I bother put it in a locker? Everything you just said makes perfect sense, but there was something written inside. It was about the headmaster, but your father.
What? If that's
Could that mean that video is real too? Video?
Makoto.
I think everything is finally starting to fit together to reveal a cohesive picture. Although I'm afraid that picture might be worse than anything we could have ever imagined. What are you talking about? Fuck you, that's what. I need to go investigate those lockers right now. I need to confirm what you just said with my own two eyes. Oh, let me give you the headmaster's notebook. That way you can...
So...
That will be necessary. If I'm right about this, I shouldn't have any problem opening the locker with my own handbook. After all, it would seem that it's my locker. Your locker?
Makoto.
If you watch this, it'll all make sense. A DVD. And it says Class 78, Urgent Interviews.
So...
I found it in the hidden room after you left.
Anyway...
I'll have time to explain exactly what I think it means. So just watch it and see for yourself. I think you'll realize exactly what it means. You'll understand when you find my pocketbook in a place none of us have ever seen before. None of this makes sense right now. But I guess this means there's some more important clue on this DVD?
Makoto.
Oh, and now it's my turn. Do you have a second to listen to my ramble?
In other words...
So as it turns out, the arrangement I've made didn't stick. What I mean is I'm less and less sure of everything, even my own feelings. You're talking about your dad, right? I can never find the answer to the questions I wanted to ask for the rest of my life. And all because of the mastermind.
However,
but there's one thing I am sure of. When it comes to the mastermind, there's no room in my heart for forgiveness.
I
swore to destroy the mastermind. This is just one more reason to follow through on that. Kyoko's eyes burned with a fire of determination. Anyway, the determination to defeat the mastermind. It's strange to be confronted with his death and suddenly feel this way. I couldn't care less if my father had found happiness. Undertale reference?
Why?
So why is it? Why does it bother me so much to know how he suffered? It's ridiculous. There's just no understanding it, I guess. She let out a small laugh as she said it. But her smile was filled with sorrow.
Whew.
So, that's it for my rambling. There's still much to do before I can consider my task complete. Yeah, you're right.
Hey.
But keep this in mind. There is only ever one absolute truth. Whether that truth serves justice or suffering. Whether it's the greatest truth or the worst. What do you mean?
Makoto.
Even if the truth you uncover is filled with hopelessness, you still can't give up hope. Absolutely not, because all I can do is keep moving forward. That's pretty much all I'm good at, you know? Indeed. Sorry if that was strange.
So then.
Anyway, I need to get going. I'll see you at the class trial. Leaving behind that final farewell, Kyoko was gone. I better get going myself. I've got that DVD from Kyoko. She heads to the AV room to check it out. Kyoko says something about hopeless truth. But no matter what happens, I won't lose hope. Even if it's the worst truth in the world. I can't afford to lose. Just Leon staring at you and that's it. Oh God. Okay. 80 room time. There's absolutely nothing in here. It's just a normal empty cardboard box. Okay. This should be able to play DVDs just fine. Well then, I better take a look. I took the DVD Kyoko gave me and put it in the player. It said that it was playing, but nothing appeared on screen. I stared into the black of the monitor. It must have been only a few seconds, but to me it felt like an eternity. And then all of a sudden, an image appeared. Oh my god, Sayaka. Sayaka? It took me a total surprise. I hadn't seen Sayaka in who knows how long. And there she was. So you fit a phase in. Hey, you. You're finally awake.
Okay then. Are you ready to begin?
The voice I heard was of the man positioned on one side of the screen. It was the voice of a middle-aged man.
I do apologize, but I hope you don't mind if I record our conversation. I'm a little slow, you know. I never really got the hang of taking notes while having a conversation.
It sounded like he was trying to make a joke, but Sayaka's tense face didn't move a single millimeter.
So this video is meant to serve as a kind of contract substitute. It's not that I don't trust you guys. It's more like insurance. So please don't worry too much.
It was an awkward joke.
Now then, let me get straight to the point. There is a chance that you may have to spend the rest of your life here in the school. Can you accept that?
You want me to accept that? Sayaka was obviously at a total loss. It made total sense. Who would agree to spending the rest of your life in this school?
I
accept. What?
Thank you. And I'm sorry about all this. Well, I can promise you that I will do everything in my power to keep you safe. As the headmaster of Hope's Peak Academy, I give you my word.
As if on cue, that's where the video cut out. There was a lot I hadn't understood until now, but this only lists. I simply couldn't comprehend what I heard. Because I know how much Sayaka wanted to get out of here. I know how much she wanted to escape and pursue her dreams with her friends again. She wanted that so bad she tried to frame me for murder. So why? Why would she say yes to living here for the rest of her life? As I sat there thinking about it, I noticed a sudden light. On the monitor, the video that I thought was finished flashed black back on screen. Can't talk. My eyes darted back to the screen. And if I was confused before, what I saw next pushed me right over the edge. Huh? What I saw was me. Impossibly, undeniably, me.
So, Makoto, before we begin, I should let you know that I'll be recording our conversation.
Yes.
Me and the headmaster were looking at each other. He and I were having what seemed like a fairly normal conversation. But the I in the here and now had absolutely no memory of it. I had no memory of ever meeting the headmaster, much less sitting down to talk to him like this.
Now, shall we get straight to the point? Makoto, there's a chance you may have to spend the rest of your life here in the school. Can you accept that?
Yes.
This can't be real. I said yes?
I'm sorry I'm putting you through all this.
Well, I mean, we don't have much of a choice, do we?
But I promise that as long as you're in this school, I will do everything I can to protect you. As the headmaster of Hope's Peak Academy, that's the very least I can do for you.
Once again, the video cut out. From there, the video repeated the same scene again and again with the others. Byakuya, Toko, Hina, everyone. They all said that they agreed to live in this school forever. And then Kyoko. Her interview with him had been recorded just as clearly. Without a doubt, she had met him. She sat down with the headmaster of Hope's Peak Academy, her father. And when he asked her his question, she answered the same as everyone else. She accepted a life within the school. Just as Kyoko's interview was wrapping up, the monitor suddenly went black. Huh? It wasn't just the monitor, the DVD player itself had apparently turned off. Which of course meant the DVD wasn't playing anymore. The heck just happened?
Say what?
Oopsie, looks like it broke. Out of service. What just happened just to break just now?
Too bad.
No, then, when, doesn't matter. Failure can strike anywhere, anytime. That's what failure is, right? Failure, my ass, you cut the power on purpose. Monokuma, you bitch. I agree with that statement. Well, whatever. Even if I watch the whole thing, it'd just be more the same. He'll ask them the question and they'll all say yes. I couldn't help myself. I had a huge, exasperated sigh, but as I did, I remembered something.
That's right.
I fainted too. When I woke up, I noticed a strange feeling of separation within myself. A disconnect. Thinking back on it now, at that point, my memory was gone. At that time, I'd forgotten. I couldn't remember why I'd come to this school, and I couldn't remember what my alternate ability was. But what would make you forget all that?
Hey.
Strange, isn't it? It's hard to imagine it happened by chance. It seems much too convenient. A convenient outcome. Something that seems so too obviously work in favor of the mastermind. Does that mean I've lost my memory too? What about the others? Have we all forgotten? Or... I'm looking at you bitch so many times now. Bing, bing, bong. He do be a bitch.
For anything that has a start, there has to be an end. And if the end comes, then that means it's time for a fresh start.
I don't know how many people remember this, probably no one. That quote there, I put that at the season 2 spawn. On a sign, a couple of signs behind IKEA. The IKEA at the season 2 spawn, I put that on signs behind it. People read it out, but they never knew where it came from. I put that quote behind IKEA in season 2. The spawn IKEA, of course, not the actual IKEA.
There is no night that doesn't have a dawn. Although that dawn is totally pitch black, there is no storm that won't eventually end. Of course, then that leads to drought. But as I said, every end is a promise of a new beginning.
It's actually quite a good quote.
Which is why I'm sure we'll get to meet again, because the end is only the beginning. Anyway, let's get started. The beginning of the end of the class trial. Everyone gather once again at you know where.
It's about to begin again. The class trial is going to start. The final class trial. The last time all of our lives will be on the line. The last time hope and despair are on the line. I don't have a choice. I have to do this. Okay then, this is the end of the stream. This is where we're ending it, guys. This is where we're fucking ending it. The end of the investigation. That's where we're leaving it, with Sayaka. That was really... So what do you guys think? That's the investigation. All of the clues have been handed to you. You have all of the clues. Can you untangle the mystery? Can you find out what the fuck happened? It's okay if you haven't, because there's so much going on. This is where the game is really good. I mean, yeah. It does. The actual backstory behind this game is fucking amazing. And on Thursday, we will find out what this backstory is. Honestly, I will say, there is a couple of really big plot twists. It really is not what you're expecting at all. It's really cool. So I really hope you all enjoy this. And I really hope you... you're here for Thursday's stream where we actually do it. But I will say, Thursday, it'll be a longer stream because the trial is quite long, I think. You have some ideas? That's Pog. That sucks, Sephor. but it's really fucking cool. And I will say, anyone who misses it, once we're done with this game, we'll leave it for a couple of weeks, then we'll start the second one so we can have Chack game. We already called the plot twist Leon. Maybe. Just saying. 22 became IRL Danganronpa, I would. Oh my god. would even be surprised. I mean, I think I would be surprised if that happened, Rose. It would not be very good. But yeah, it was a very fun stream. I was very hyped. I'm actually still quite hyped. I'm just really looking forward to getting to the end of this game, because I fucking love this game. Once we end the game, what will Tuesday and Thursday streams be? There is something I'm considering, but not completely sure yet. So, but in the meantime, I don't know. But I'll think of something, and I'll ask you all for opinions and stuff. But for now, that's the end of the stream. Is anyone live? Any teas? I cannot, because I'm still completely unsure what I want to do. I'm still thinking, really. Is anyone I know live? No one who isn't huge. There's someone playing Fortnite that I know, but nah, we're good. Raid Leon, I wish I could. Okay, that was a fun stream, guys. I'll see you all on Thursday for more Danganronpa. Or also, actually, no. I might... This isn't guaranteed, because I've got a load of things to do tomorrow. But it should be a Tato stream tomorrow. But I cannot promise it, because there is a bunch of things I need to do to fix a couple problems on the server. Also, I've been exhausted the past today, and I'll probably be exhausted tomorrow, so I can't promise there'll be a stream tomorrow. But if there is a stream, Tato. And I will also do the Sans Mask that Haley done. Yeah, but yeah, 100% Danganronpa Thursday, actually finishing the game. It's going to be absolutely pog. I cannot wait to get to it. So yeah, I will see you all then. Bye, guys.